Hey, I'm Michał Pierzchała, a principal engineer at Callstack, and this is React Native Optimization in Practice, a series of short videos illustrating the best practices for optimal React Native performance. This episode is about React Compiler. React Compiler is a project from the React core team that enables auto-memoization of our code. Essentially, it enables React to re-render less without changing your code. So I have a sample project here. It's a React Native project. We have small app with some state for value, for count. This state is then passed and updated to count button and text input component. So we have a button and we have a text input here. So let's install this project. Let's start our Metro server and let's follow the instruction, right? So once we have a dev server connected, we can run our Android or iOS app. We'll choose Android for now. And we can open our emulator here. The build is successful and our app is here. And indeed, it's a button that we can click and it's a text input that also updates some state inside. So this lesson is about auto memoization. So how we can inspect what's re-rendering in our application so that we will need to memoize it. To do that, it's best to open the React Native DevTools and inspect our component tree and turn on the highlight updates when components render. Once we have that, we will see that React DevTools will highlight those components that are re-rendering. So when we click or when we add some text here, we can see that it re-renders. What we're not really expecting as a product or app developers is that when we update the text, we wouldn't like React to re-render the button and vice versa. When we click the button, we don't want the text input and other unrelated state to update. And this is where React Compiler helps us to automatically apply memoizations and optimizations that we would normally need to apply through React Memo or use Memo or use callback hooks. So let's see what we have here. The guide is telling us to follow instructions on the React Compiler chapter. So this chapter is a part of, it's a best practice from the Ultimate Guide to React Native Optimization book. It's a book that we wrote at Callstack that's about, as you can imagine, React Native optimization techniques. There are how-tos and guides on how to optimize profile, debug, performance, and how to apply those in forms of best practice. So you can download your free copy here, and let's open it and go to the React Compiler best practice chapter. And let's see what's necessary to prepare our code base for React Compiler. We'll need to install ESLint and ESLint plugin. We actually don't need to do that. This is something that you will likely want to include in your project. But for our sake, we're rather interested in just running the compiler. So let's do it. Let's run the compiler. The compiler is actually a Babel plugin. So let us install it in our project. And now that it's installed, we'll need to configure our Babel config file to use that plugin. So let's do that. And let's configure React Compiler config to target React 19 because we're in a project that has React 19 and it's using React Native 79. So let's save that. And what we will need to do is we will need to reset cache of our Metro server, because otherwise it would use some stale information from our Babel configuration. So now that we have that, we'll need to restart our application. It's now restarted. And we can open our DevTools. And what's different this time is that we have those memo labels that tell us that this component has been auto-memoized by React compiler. We can see that app and count pattern and text input component are now auto-memoized. So let's see how this works in practice. And it works as we would expect. Now we're entering some input and our state of the button is not changing. And vice versa, when we change the state of the button by clicking on it, it's not causing the text input to update. And we can further verify it with React Profiler. So instead of relying on highlighting the updates, which by the way, you can turn on in the settings, highlight updates when component render, we can run our profiler, click three times, update some state here and there. Can now stop profiling. The profiler recorded six commits or changes to React state. And what we can observe here, we can zoom in to this part, to the scroll view, and see that pressable, which is our button, our count button, is re-rendering because its props changed. And the text input component is not re-rendering. It's also auto-memoized. The profiler confirms that this component did not render. And we can see that through subsequent clicks. And here we should start seeing the reverse situation where we actually update the state of input component and it changes expectedly. And the count button is now not the rendering because it's also auto-memoized. And this happens as we further change the text input state. So this is how you can use React Compiler in your code base, not only in React web projects, but also in React Native. Thanks for watching. I hope you have not only a better understanding of what React Compiler is, but also how you can implement that knowledge in your project. For more content like this, please follow us on your favorite social media platforms. See ya.